In a recent press release from the Illinois Comptroller's Office, Illinois has over $14 billion of unpaid debts. With university enrollments declining, social service agencies closing, and Chicago public schools borrowing money just to stay open, lawmakers had to think of creative ways of helping solve the state's fiscal crisis, one of which is legalizing the recreational use of marijuana. In March, Democratic State Senators Heather Steens and Representative Kelly Cassidy introduced a bill to legalize the recreational use of marijuana. The proposal that was held from a vote to give lawmakers time to review has remained controversial in the community. Filipino Americans weigh in on the possible legalization of marijuana in Illinois. Though there are a number of individuals who are strongly opposed to it, there is one family we spoke with who is 100% rooting for it. 47-year-old Michaela Casper, a mother with 8 children, is not concerned about the possible misuse of marijuana if the bill is passed.
The connection between the use of marijuana, it does not increase the accidents on the streets. It's the opposite.
There are 29 states and District of Columbia that have legalized the use of medical marijuana. 8 of those states and Washington, D.C. have legalized recreational use of marijuana. Casper agrees that this proposal makes some people nervous, especially in Chicago, where crime rate is high. Lisa San Diego feels otherwise.
There's a great potential for abuse, and if we consider that there are more recreational users than there are medical users for marijuana.
Lisa says, though Illinois is really financially desperate, the end does not justify the means.
If we use the models that are currently being used by other states, we've already seen the great potential for abuse. Now, not to discount medical users, there are other drugs existing that can be used with proven safety and efficacy.
According to the Marijuana Policy Project, the legalization in Illinois could earn the state between $350 and $700 million a year. Lawmakers are expected to return to Springfield for another session in January. Connie Macatula de Leon, ABS-CBN News, Crystal Lake, Illinois.